bread, the most important food in our diet, is healthy, versatile, and delicious. But have you ever wondered how the bread you eat gets to be so light and fluffy? Let's talk about the chemical reactions in the bread making process. A typical recipe of bread has flour, yeast, water, and salt. With flour consisting of a high level of gliadin and glutenin proteins, the classes of protein are collectively referred to as gluten. Let's start by mixing flour and water. When hydrated, the protein form a network held together. They literally begin to stick to each other through hydrogen bond and disulfide cross links. The hydration is essential for gluten development. Then, yeast is added. Yeast are single-cell microorganisms classified as a member of fungus kingdom. But yeast can it be started in flour. It needs simpler sugar to feed on. Lucky for it, when hydrated, flour contains the enzyme called amylase, necessary to break down starch into simpler sugar with its maltose. This process is known as autolyse. Then, the sugars are continued to break down into glucose by the maltase in yeast. Lastly, salt is added to the dough and not just a matter of taste. The presence of sodium and chloride ions are essential for the convergence of protein chains, contributing to the formation of a stronger and more elastic dough. When dough is kneaded, the hydrated flexible protein is spread, providing more opportunity to form cross-link between the protein. Kneading also incorporates air, which helps to form strong disulfide bonds. If properly kneaded, the baked bread consists of a network of long, shredded wooden strands, which create a texture as we're seeing. Then, the dough will rest for a period of time, which is called fermentation. During this period, the bacteria in yeast consume the glucose, decompose from the autolyse, and release carbon dioxide and ethanol. It's the formation of tiny air bubbles, which causes the dough to rise. But instead of parting to let the gas out, the flexible dough traps pockets of carbon dioxide, inflating as it does so, and create wide open spaces inside the loaf. Once the dough has risen, it's ready to go in the oven. When it is under high temperatures, a complex chemical reaction occurs on the surface. The carbon molecules contained in the sugar combine with the amino acids of the proteins. This chemical recombination is the Maillard reaction. Melanoidins is one of the potential end products. These act as brown pigment given the bread its brown coloration. Hundreds of other organic compounds are also formed. A subset of these can contribute to new flavors and aroma. Now, who say chemistry can get in the kitchen?